Hi students, a very good morning. In the last section we discussed about the discovery of electron, proton, neutrons. Hope you understood the points about the discovery of electron, proton and neutron. So today we are going to discuss about the atom models proposed by J.J. Thomson, Rutherford and atomic number, mass number, etc. So J.J. Thomson discovered the electron in 1896. After that, Goldstein discovered the proton. And J.J. Thomson put forward an atomic model. The protons are uniformly distributed in the spherical atom. He suggested that atoms are spherical. So the positive charge, that is protons, are uniformly distributed in the spherical atom and the electrons are embedded. Electrons are embedded in the atom. Like that, the seeds in the watermelon. The edible portion of watermelon is in red color, you know that. And seeds are embedded. Like that, in a spherical atom, protons are uniformly distributed. Protons are uniformly distributed and electrons are embedded. And this model is known as plum pudding model or a raisin pudding model or watermelon model. You know that what is a pudding? Okay. Nuts and the fruits are embedded in the pudding. Okay, so the model is also known as watermelon model, plum pudding model, or raisin pudding model. Okay, when you eat plum cake, you can understand this concept. But the model was failed to explain the stability of atom. Okay, the Thomson model, plum pudding model or watermelon model was not able to explain the stability of the atom. And also it is not accord with the Rutherford scattering experiments. In 1911, Rutherford and his students conducted an experiment. It is called scattering experiments. Okay. Thin gold foil scattering experiments. The students are Ernest Giger and Madsen. Okay, Madsen, two students of Rutherford. Okay, so we move to the scattering experiment. So remember that J.J. Thomson model has two drawbacks, mainly the two drawbacks. One is he couldn't explain the stability of the atom. How stable? Because the positive charge and negative charge are close together. The electrons are embedded in the positive charge. So he couldn't explain the stability of the atom. Then the second drawback is he couldn't explain the Rutherford scattering experiments. So we move to the Rutherford scattering experiments. Rutherford took a thin gold foil. Okay. A thin gold foil and an alpha particle source. You just understand that. And a circular screen. And he take a circular screen. Okay. He took a thin gold foil and a beam of alpha particle. A beam of alpha particle. Alpha particle is equivalent to helium nucleus. Alpha particle is equivalent to helium nucleus. In the last class, the neutrons are discovered by James Chadwick by the bombardment of alpha particle into lighter elements such as beryllium and boron. Okay, so alpha particle is equivalent to helium nucleus. The observations are very important and
he observed that I take only one atom. He observed that most of the alpha particles are undeflected. Most of the alpha particles are undeflected. Most of the alpha particles are undeflected to the gold foil. Okay, that's why we put a screen around the gold foil. Okay, he want to know where the alpha particles goes. So that's why he put a circular screen around the thin gold foil. And he concluded, he observed that most of the alpha rays are undeflected through the gold foil. About 99%, the first point is 99.9% alpha particles undeflected. Okay, 99.9%, most of the alpha particles are undeflected through the gold foil. ഒരു ഡിഫ്ലക്ഷനും ഇല്ലാതെ ഗോൾഡ് ഫോയിലിലൂടെ ആൽഫ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ് കടന്നുപോയി. ആൻഡ് ദ സെക്കൻഡ് പോയിന്റ് ഈസ് വെരി ഫ്യൂ ഓർ എ ഫ്യൂ ആൽഫ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ് ആർ ഡിഫ്ലക്റ്റഡ് ഇൻ സ്മോൾ ആംഗിൾസ്. യു കാൻ സീ ഇൻ ദ പിക്ചർ. ഓക്കെ, എ വെരി ഫ്യൂ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ്. A few particles are deflected through small angles. Suppose if the alpha particle is going this direction, the angle is small. Okay, so it is deflected through small angles. And a third observation, very few, that is 1 among 20,000. 1 among 20,000 alpha particles are reflected back or bounced back. These are the three important observations from the scattering experiments conducted by Rutherford and his students. Hope you understand. Once again, he took a thin gold foil. And these are placed inside a circular screen. The screen is coated with a zinc sulfurescent material. Okay, remember that? The screen is coated with a fluorescent material. We cannot see the alpha particles. That's why he put a screen and it is coated with a zinc sulfide, fluorescent material. When he bombarded a beam of alpha radiations, okay, he observed that the observation is 99.9% alpha particles are undeflected. That is, most of the alpha particles are undeflected, and a few alpha particles are deflected in the small angles. Okay, you can see in the picture small angles, and very few, 1 among 20,000. Okay, 1 among 20,000 alpha particle is bounced back or reflected back. Okay, from this observation, he concluded something. The conclusions are, most part of an atom is empty since most of the alpha rays are undeflected. ആറ്റത്തിന്റെ മിക്കവാറും ഭാഗങ്ങളെല്ലാം എംപ്റ്റി ആണ്, ശൂന്യമാണ്. വൈ? മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസ് ആർ അൺഡിഫ്ലക്റ്റഡ്. മിക്കവാറും എല്ലാ പാർട്ടിക്കിൾസും ഒരു ഡിഫ്ലക്ഷനും ഇല്ലാതെയാണ് കടന്നുപോയത്. അരെ ക്ലിയർ? ഓക്കെ, സോ മോസ്റ്റ് പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് ആൻ ആറ്റം ഈസ് എംപ്റ്റി സിൻസ് മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി ആൽഫ റേസ് ആർ അൺഡിഫ്ലക്റ്റഡ്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഫസ്റ്റ് കൺക്ലൂഷൻ. And second thing is, the positive charge and the mass of an atom is concentrated at a particular point is called a nucleus of the atom. Okay, you can see this.
most of the positive charges, leave all positive charge and the mass of the atom is concentrated at the center of the atom. The center is known as nucleus. Okay, the center is known as nucleus. So, nucleus, a new term is proposed by Rutherford, nucleus, center of the atom. Center of the atom. Center of the atom. Yes, it is positively charged. That's why the alpha particle is positive. Okay, alpha particle is positive. When the alpha particle approaches the positive center, it is deflected due to repulsion. You know that like charge repels and opposite charge attracts. So, when the alpha particle reaches the positive center, it is deflected. And when the alpha particle is directly collided with the center of the atom, that is nucleus, it bounces back or reflected to large angles. I think you understand. Okay, so most of the mass, or we can say that all the positive charge and the mass of the atom is concentrated at a particular point is called a nucleus, the center of the atom. And he give the size of the atom. If the size of the atom, size of atom is equal to 10 raised to minus 10 meter. And size of the nucleus, size of nucleus is equal to 10 raised to minus 15 meter. Okay, this is 1 angstrom. This is 1 femtometer. He already studied in the first chapter. 10 raised to minus 10 meter is equal to 1 angstrom. And 10 raised to minus 15 meter is 1 femtometer. Okay, so the size of the nucleus is very small. Okay, the size of the nucleus is very small. Okay. To understand that, you imagine the size of the ball is, the size of the cricket ball is the nucleus. And the whole ground, the cricket ground is assumed to be atom. Okay. There is a comparison, not exact one. If nucleus is as in the size of a cricket ball, the size of the atom is the cricket ground. Okay, the ground is the size of the atom. Very small size as compared to the size of the atom. Okay, nucleus and the size, atom and the size side compare ayumbo valare cherudana. Okay, yes. Then, next one. Another conclusion. Electrons are surrounded the nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus with a high velocity or very high speed. Okay, electrons are revolving around the nucleus with a very high speed. That is another conclusion. And the electrons and nucleus is held together by electrostatic force or Coulombic forces of attraction. Okay, how the electrons and nucleus is held? In nucleus there are protons. All the protons are, all the positive charges accumulated in the center of the atom. The nucleus and the electrons are revolving around. Okay, the electrons are attracted by the nucleus by electrostatic force or Coulombic forces of attraction. Are you clear? Nucleus um electron um thammil electrostatic forces vadiyana pidichu nirthirikkunnathu. And finally, the number of proton in the nucleus is equal to number of electron around the nucleus. Okay. As whole atom is neutral. Totally the atom is neutral. As whole Actin is electrically neutral because the number of proton in the nucleus is equal to number of electron around the nucleus. Atom endana atom totally electrically neutral aanu kaaranam endana number of proton is equal to number of electrons. Proton in the electron in the ennam equal aanu. Okay, so this model is compared to the solar system. Sun in the center and the planets are revolving around the sun. Similarly, center of the atom nucleus, electrons are revolving around the nucleus as planets revolving around the sun. That's why it is sometimes called a solar model of atom. Sorry. Okay, the model, the Rutherford model, sometimes called a solar model of atom. Okay, as the place nucleus, as the place of sun nucleus, and in the case of planets we take electrons. So electrons are revolving around the nucleus as similar to the solar system. That's why the model is also known as solar model of the atom. Remember that he couldn't also explain the stability of the atom. Okay, he states that atom is electrically neutral. All the positive charges concentrated at a particular point. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. All these things he stated, but he couldn't explain the stability of the atom. Why? When electrons are revolving around the atom, it continuously irradiates its energy. Okay, if the electron are revolving around the nucleus, it continuously irradiates its energy, and finally what happens? Nucleus is positive and the electrons are revolving around the nucleus. When it irradiates energy, it's attracted by the nucleus and collides with the nucleus. As you know what happens when positive charge and negative charge combines. Okay. So he couldn't explain the stability of the atom. Are you clear? And second one, he couldn't explain the spectrum of atom, hydrogen spectrum. We will discuss later. So the first drawback is couldn't explain the stability. Couldn't explain the stability of the atom. Second drawback is he couldn't explain the hydrogen spectrum. Hydrogen spectrum. Stability varayanum pattilla. Hydrogen spectrum explain cheyanum mark sadichilla. Rutherford nu sadichilla. Anyway, an important development is the center of the atom is called a nucleus. And electrons are revolving around the nucleus. That's a development in the Rutherford atomic model. Okay, most of the part of an atom is empty. All positive charge and the mass of the atom is concentrated at the center of the atom nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. It is the path is called orbits. Okay. The path is called orbits. The number of proton is equal to number of electron. That's why atom is electrically neutral. The electron and the nucleus is held together by an electrostatic forces of atom. These are the important conclusions made by Rutherford. And he has also some drawbacks. The drawbacks, he couldn't explain the stability, and also he couldn't explain the hydrogen atom. Before we entering into the hydrogen spectrum, we should learn something about the atomic number, mass number, isotopes, isobars, isotones, etc. I think you know these things. Anyway, we have discussed atomic number, mass number, isobars, isotopes, etc. Okay, what is atomic number? Atomic number, a very important thing. Atomic number, it is represented by Z.
Z. Okay. Atomic number.
Atomic number is the total number of protons. Okay, listen. The number of proton in the nucleus or number of electron in a neutral atom. Okay. We consider neutral atom. When we consider the neutral atom, the number of proton and number of electrons are same. But in the case of ion, anion or cation, the number of proton is not equal to number of electrons. So we consider only neutral atom, we can say number of electron. So once again, the atomic number is the total number of protons in the nucleus or electrons in a neutral atom. Okay, ഒരു ആറ്റത്തിന്റെ ന്യൂക്ലിയസിലുള്ള നമ്പർ ഓഫ് പ്രോട്ടോൺ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് ഇലക്ട്രോൺ, ആറ്റം എങ്ങനെയായിരിക്കണം? ന്യൂട്രൽ ആയിരിക്കണം. ഇലക്ട്രിക്കലി ന്യൂട്രൽ ആണെങ്കിൽ മാത്രമേ നമ്മൾ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് ഇലക്ട്രോൺസ് കൺസിഡർ ചെയ്യാവുള്ളൂ. Otherwise, you take only number of protons. So, atomic number Z is equal to number of proton. Proton is represented by P. Okay. Or it is equal to number of electron in a neutral atom. That remember. Number of electron in a neutral atom. Okay. The next is mass number. Mass number. Mass number A. Mass number is represented by A. What is mass number? It is the total number of proton and number of neutrons. Okay. Mass number is the total number of proton and neutron in the nucleus. Nucleus ഇനകത്തുള്ള പ്രോട്ടോണിന്റെയും ന്യൂട്രോണിന്റെയും ടോട്ടൽ നമ്പർ ആണ് മാസ് നമ്പർ. സോ വി ക്യാൻ റൈറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് മാസ് നമ്പർ എ ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു ടോട്ടൽ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് പ്രോട്ടോൺ. വാട്ട് ഈസ് ടോട്ടൽ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് പ്രോട്ടോൺ? അറ്റോമിക് നമ്പർ Z. അറ്റോമിക് നമ്പർ Z ആൻഡ് number of neutrons. Number of neutrons. Well, what is number of neutrons? How we can calculate number of neutrons? Number of neutrons is equal to number of neutrons is equal to mass number minus atomic number. Atomic number. So mass number is the total number of proton and neutrons. So we can write that A minus Z. Mass number is A, atomic number is Z. This is number of neutrons. Neutron de ennam kandupidikkan A minus Z cheyyanam. Okay, are you clear? So this is an important terms. Okay. Atomic number, the number of proton or number of electron in a neutral atom. Mass number, total number of proton and neutron in the nucleus. And number of neutron can be calculated by mass number minus atomic number. One more thing. The proton and the neutron present in the nucleus is collectively called nucleons. Okay, proton and neutrons collectively called nucleons. Remember that. So what are nucleons? The proton and neutrons present in the nucleus is called nucleons. Okay, one mark question sometime asking. And we move to the another important things, isotopes, isobars, isotopes. What are isotopes? You study. What are isotopes? Isotopes are atoms of same elements with a different mass number. Okay, same element. Same elements of different mass number.
different mass number.
Okay, one thing I forgot to tell you, an atom is represented by an atom X is represented by like this. Left, okay, left subscript Z, left superscript mass number. Okay, for example, hydrogen 1, 1. What it means? Atomic number is 1, mass number is 1. Then oxygen 8, 16. Atomic number 8, mass number 16. In order representation, in some other textbook we can see that like this. This is order representation. Okay, 8, 16 in the right superscript. Okay, are you clear? 16 in the right superscript. It is order representation. This is the correct representation nowadays we are using. So, same elements of different mass number. Examples: hydrogen 1, 1, hydrogen 1, 2, hydrogen 1, 3. Okay, same element, atomic number is same. And the mass numbers are different. 1, 2, 3. As we know that this is protium. In the last class I explained, hydrogen contains only one proton. That's why hydrogen is known as protium. Proton, hydrogen is also known as proton. And the isotope is protium. Okay, then this is deuterium. One proton and one neutron. One proton and one neutron, so total two. Are you clear? Then this is tritium. Tritium T, the symbol is T. 1, 3. Okay, atomic number is 1 and mass number is 3. Okay, so which element having only proton? That's hydrogen. Okay, which element having only proton? That is hydrogen. All other elements have proton and neutrons. Okay, so this is one of the example. Next is carbon isotope. Carbon 6, 12, carbon 6, 13, carbon 6, 14. These are isotopes of carbon. Another is an radioactive element, uranium. Radioactive element uranium. Uranium 92-234, uranium 92-235, and uranium 92-238. These are the isotopes of uranium. Uranium is radioactive. Then second point is isobars. Isobars. Atoms of different element with the same mass number. Atoms of different elements with the same mass number is called isobars. For example, phosphorus 15, 32, sulfur 16, 32. Different atoms, atomic number is different, 15. 15 protons and 15 electrons. 16 protons and 16 electrons. But the mass number is same. Phosphorus 32, sulfur 32. Another example, carbon 14 and nitrogen 14. Okay, different atoms. Because of mass number is, sorry, atomic number is different, but mass number is same. So different atoms of same mass number is called isobars. Other we can write thorium. Thorium 90-234 and uranium 92-234. So you can collect more example for isobars from the textbook. Okay. So these are isobars. And another is isotones. In competitive examination, isotones are important. Isotons means atoms of different element of neutrons. Same number of neutrons. Atoms of different elements having same number of neutrons are called isotons. For example, phosphorus 1531, sulfur 1632. Number of proton is 15. Number of neutron is equal to 16. Okay, and remember that number of proton is equal to number of electron in a neutral atom. So proton and electron are same. Number of neutron is 16. Here number of proton is equal to 16. Number of neutron is also 16. So number of neutrons are same. Number of neutrons are same. This is called isotone. Another one. Nitrogen 715. Carbon 614. What is the number of proton? It is 7. Number of proton here 6. Number of neutron 15 minus 7. Mass number minus atomic number. How much? 8. 15 minus 7, 8. 40 minus 6. Number of neutron is equal to 8. Are you clear? So isotones are atoms of different elements. Or we can say that different element having same number of neutrons is called isotones. Okay, so these are the examples for isobars, isotopes and isotones. Remember that you just understand these concepts. CBSE deleted this portion from your syllabus because of COVID-19. Okay, you remember that. You just understand these concepts. Otherwise, while we doing the problem, we cannot follow that. That's why I briefly explain these things. In the next section, we will discuss the dual nature of matter, the development towards the Bohr model. We already seen that Rutherford model has some drawbacks. This drawback is corrected by another scientist, Niels Bohr. Okay, Niels Bohr. So next topic is development towards Niels Bohr atom model or Bohr model of atom. So tomorrow we will discuss all these things in detail. Thank you.